The steel drum, the instrument itself, and kind of show its versatility by playing a lot of different styles of music. So you're going to hear some stuff that sounds very steel bandy, and you're going to hear some stuff that sounds like that you would never anticipate hearing from a steel drum band, okay? And then we try to find some medium ground in between here and there, too. The first tune we're going to do is a little bit of a departure, but it lays really well on the drums. It's called it's called Obla Di, Obla Da by the Beatles.
Mm-hmm.
you may have heard of a guy with the initials BM, not Bill Murray, his name is Bob Marley. We do a couple of his tunes. The first one we're going to play is Jammin'. Schedule tonight until about 8 o'clock. We plan on playing at least a half an hour past that because we just like playing. And you couldn't ask for a better night for it, so we might as well take advantage. Plus, we're being live streamed to like 3 people on Facebook, so we want to make sure that they get their money's worth as well. And if you stick around after we're done playing, we'd be more than happy to let you touch the instruments, poke at them a little bit, explain how they're built. If you've never played a steel drum or been up close and seen a steel drum, this is probably one of the few opportunities you'll ever get. So feel free to come up after and check it out. These instruments right here with the single drum are called lead pans or tenors. Okay, they're our soprano voice, kind of like a barbershop quartet. These guys are our double seconds. They're our alto. They do a little like guitar strumming and occasionally take the melody. These are our cellos. They play a little bit more rhythm stuff, but every once in a while we try to give them a moment to shine. And we usually have, we also have a couple sets of bass pans, and those are 6 full-size barrels that are, the notes are so low you can only fit 3 notes on each barrel. And since we have 2 sets of those and no semi, we let Clay play bass guitar back there, and he does all our bass stuff for us. and he does a great job. And the reason I'm explaining that a little bit is the next tune that we're going to play is a great steel band tune, but it's originally by 311. It's kind of a fusion rock band, for those of you who are familiar. It's called Amber, and throughout the course of this tune, you can hear each voice take its own line, its own melody, so to speak. So as we play this tune, see if you can't pick out the different voices in our ensembles. This is Amber. Anybody to raise their hand if they're old enough to remember Harry Belafonte. But you can quietly sit in adulation that we are going to play a couple of Harry Belafonte tunes that you might recognize. The first one is Yellow Bird. It started as a Haitian folk song back in 1893, so it's been around a while. If you remember it as a Haitian folk song, thank you so much for coming. Thank you. some steel band style, at least usual steel band style. We try to knock this out early. If you've ever seen the steel band before, have you, anybody here seen panhandlers in the past? Seen us in the past? Thank you very much. If you've ever been to a panhandler's performance, you know my complete disdain for this song. But a very good friend of mine loves this song, so I promised her I'd arrange it for us. And ever since then, people have really enjoyed it, so we keep playing it. If you wouldn't mind, don't clap after we play it, so I have an excuse to get rid of this tune. It's called Call Me Maybe by Carly Rae Jepsen. Those that we play, it's called Rant and Rave. up the set list as we go tonight. We're skipping a few things here and there. So we decided to jump one of the tunes and play another Caribbean-style tune by an artist you might have heard of if you're familiar with that style of music, the Mighty Sparrow. It's called Both of Them. And Chris, of course, was like, well, why don't we just play Both of Them? I didn't think it was funny either. So I get my time in front of the camera. So this song by the Mighty Sparrow is about a gentleman who couldn't decide between two women. That's why it's called Both of Them. I'm sorry if that wasn't politically correct. I didn't write the song. So if you came here with your sweetheart tonight, this is about the only chance you'll get to slow dance with them. I understand there's not a whole lot of room. There's like a foot and a half right here, and a little bit over here. But this is another Harry Belafonte tune called Jamaica Farewell. Thank you. next tune is about as far of a stretch as we go with the steel drums, playing music that was never even dreamed of being intended on these instruments. But, like I said, we like to give the cellos a little chance to shine now and then. So they play the melody for this entire tune. It's called Royals by Lorne. Concludes the KDWB portion of our performance. We probably won't be playing any more tunes that are potentially on the Dave Ryan in the Morning Show. The next one that we're going to play, has anybody had a birthday recently? Does anybody know? Oh, there's one. Okay. This one is for you. This is our version of Happy Birthday. It's called Birthday Party. Thank you. So we got Matt Solis on the drum set back there. That's the first time you got to throw down a little bit anyway. He likes not being mic'd because then he can just play really, really loud all the time. I lied about the KDWB thing. We're gonna play this Bruno Mars tune called Grenade. I'm glad you're all excited about it. Thank you. there's few bigger names than a guy by the name of Glenn Boobsy Sharp. He's arranged for a number of steel bands, champion of Panorama several times over. He has an amazing double seconds player. And he tried his hand at composing a tune that was kind of a little bit out of the characteristic soca style. And we like to play it. It's called Hard Times. Excuse me, Hard Times. Nice change of pace, and it gives us a chance to show off our choreography. Now that you've seen us dance, you know exactly why we're drummers. The next tune that we're going to play is a pretty difficult song, but for those Star Wars fans out there, if you guys remember all the way back to the first movie, Han Solo got in a fight with Greedo in a bar. Okay, this was the last tune that Greedo ever heard. Thank you. The next one we're going to play is another Marley tune, and it offers us a nice change of pace to catch our breath. It's called Three Little Birds. Never do anything the easy way. We were looking at jazz tunes to kind of explore the idiom of jazz on these instruments, and we decided that the tune in five was easier than every other tune that we wanted to play. So this tune is by Paul Desmond. It's called Take Five. It was made famous by the Dave Brubeck Trio. Thank you. 7-year-old daughter at home, and my wife uses her as an excuse to watch the movie Little Mermaid about 1,000 times over and over and over. So much so that we had to buy the DVD because she wore out the VHS. Yes, there are still VHS out there. Yeah, I know it. But we play this tune mostly because she loves it, and she would kill me if I didn't play it. So it's called Under the Sea. This tune is just fun to play. It's Trinidad Blue Basin. I'm going to keep my mouth shut just a little bit more so we can burn three more tunes before we have to leave. Thank you. Next one we're going to play is by a progressive band called Snarky Puppy. They do this with a horn section. It's called Tio Macaco. And Tio Macaco loosely translates to Uncle Monkey. I don't know what significance that has, but it's a fun little fact. Tio Macaco by Snarky Puppy. Thank you. two more for you. Mostly because it's getting dark and it's hard to see. We're going to play the last panorama tune of the evening by Lord Kitchener. It's called The Bee's Melody. pan-handlers.org, that's .org. We are a nonprofit organization, and we do also We have another website for our outreach program. It's called panoutreach.org. And if you're interested in supporting that, what we do is we take another set of these instruments, like you see here, into various schools and supplement music ed programs for 3, 4, 5 weeks at a time. And because of support from donations like you and pull tabs that you buy at certain bars that say Chop Sync, which is our parent organization, it costs those host schools $0 to have a full steel band at their disposal for up to sometimes 9 weeks. We've done that program, which is great. We are very much looking forward to being at the Minnesota State Academy for the Blind this fall, which will present a whole new set of excellent and amazing challenges and opportunities for us. So if you are of the giving type and looking for something to throw an extra couple dollars at, it is fully tax deductible, and we definitely appreciate your support. Before we leave tonight, we're going to play an 80s tune. We waited all night to get to the 80s. It's a tune by A-ha. It's called Take On Me.